to BBC Look North. The town that never sleeps, not in summer. Anyway, tonight we look at the enduring appeal of Skegness.
We always used to come as a family together and stay in a caravan. We've just kept that tradition going.
We don't go abroad, we always come here.
I'm Alan.
I'm Jackie.
And we run the Rufford Hotel in Skegness.
Hundreds of thousands of people flock to the town every summer. We spend some time with the hoteliers that look after them.
I've got to hurry up and finish. I've got to meet Tom Jones at 2 a.m. for a kebab in Cardiff.
And at night, the bars and restaurants are packed with holidaymakers looking for a good time. We meet the people who entertain them.
Yes, here we are. Very good evening to you. Welcome to a special edition of Look North, coming live from Skegness. Abby is with me as well. I've seen up here. This doesn't look very good, does it?
Well, it doesn't. But you know, any excuse for a free ice cream, please. You and I will be here. I'll have a full forecast in about 15 minutes.
But is that this as forecast or not?
Oh, always, always.
I believe you. I believe you. And thanks very much indeed to all these people who come down. Thank you very much indeed. Enjoy yourself, won't you? Yay! Well, here we are in one of the country's top seaside resorts, the jewel in the crown of the Lincolnshire coast.
Each summer, hundreds of thousands of people head here from cities and towns across the country, swelling the population, well outnumbering the locals, filling the bars and restaurants, packing out the fish and chip shops. And the soundtrack to the town is provided by the arcades, the fun fairs and the entertainers.
It is the most amazing place, I have to say. And tonight we're celebrating Skeg Vegas, as it's affectionately known by everybody around here. We look at why the resort works, the people that make the resort tick, and why people come back year after year, generation after generation. First up tonight, our business correspondent, Sarah Corker, has this report.
From the white knuckle rides and traditional fun fairs to some gentler pursuits, Skegness has proved it has an enduring appeal.
There's four generations. I've got my dad, and then I've got my children and my grandchildren.
For the Green family from Nottingham, Skeggy is the one and only summer destination.
How long have you been coming to Skegness?
Ever since I was a child, small child. We always used to come as a family together and stay in a caravan. And we've just kept that tradition going year after year, and we love it.
What's your favourite thing about Skegness?
Going on the beach. And maybe the rides and the donkeys.
We don't go abroad, we always come here. There's just loads to do for the children. I've brought my 12-week-old here today. We're starting that tradition with her now. So yeah, we've all come, all of our generations come here.
Skegness is the birthplace of Butlins and became a popular resort for factory workers from the Midlands. Today, this coastline has the highest concentration of static caravans in Europe. This couple from Peterborough have just bought their holiday home.
I don't think we're going abroad again. I think we're just going to stay here. It's our investment and our little home from home, as you like.
I hate going abroad, mainly due to flights, airports. I hate waiting around.
Resorts like Skegness have survived the Club Med boom and the rise in the cheap package holiday. And there's been a huge investment in new attractions here on the East Coast. And this is the latest one, Altitude 44, a high wire adventure.
Tourism is worth almost £700 million to East Lindsay's economy. And last year, the region attracted 4.7 million visitors. And almost 9,000 people work directly in the tourism industry.
It's the modern age and this is a modern development.
Blue Anchor Leisure operates 14 caravan parks along the East Coast.
The pound is a little bit weak with all the effects Brexit's having on it and all the uncertainty. And people are saying is, I'd rather have multiple holidays in England and on the coast, seeing us as the more value for money holiday. And I think they're liking that.
The town is proud of its kiss-me-quick atmosphere, but it's also tried to reinvent itself.
All about being chip shops and arcades, I think that is, you need to come and discover Skegness, because there's lots of areas I think that you would be surprised on. We've got nature lands, we've got seal sanctuaries, we've got walks, we've got the Gibraltar Point nature reserves. The area itself has got so much to offer, more than just fish and chips.
Britain's coastal resorts have had their fair share of ups and downs. Yet Skeg Vegas, as it's affectionately known, continues to attract the crowds.
Yeah, the mayor mentioned the seals. I was there earlier on. See that later in the programme. Well, Sarah is here with me on the promenade. What do you think it is that makes people come back year after year?
Well, I think the rise in the popularity of the so-called staycation is really helping our British resorts. More of us are choosing to holiday at home, perhaps because it's seen as better value than going abroad. And holidaymakers here, I'm sure they'll tell you, when the sun's shining here in Skegness, the beach really is second to none. But the big challenge has always been, how do you make this into an all-year-round resort, not just reliant on the summer season? And there's been investment in new attractions, a new hotel, lots of events as well, and figures out today show that this is all working. Visitor numbers are up on 2017. 5 million people visited this region last year alone, so good news.
And did you go to the top of altitude 44?
No, I was too scared. I just went halfway up and admired the view.
Chicken! Chicken! Oh. Chicken! You didn't come on to be embarrassed by me, did you?
Oh, no!
Sarah, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Well, a couple of miles up the coast is Butlins, of course. Tonight it'll be absolutely rammed. Thousands of people will be in there right now. Well, it was the first holiday camp set up by Billy Butlin in 1936. He went on to open many more across the UK. And even now, 83 years on, it still welcomes hundreds of thousands of visitors each year. Well, the resort director is Chris Barron, and he's with us now. Chris, good evening to you.
Good evening, Peter.
I mean, it is a phenomenal story, isn't it? I mean, to think that it's still going all these years later. I mean, what's the appeal of it, do you think?
I think the fact that it keeps reinventing itself and it's current for whatever generation wants. And we're part of British history and of tourism. Whoever I talk to always has a story about Butlins. And we're still attracting 500,000 people in the middle of the 21st century.
But Billy Butlin, in 1936, wouldn't have thought that it would still be going.
I don't know. He was a real entertainer and he wanted to see always something new. And I think he'd really appreciate what we've done. And we still celebrate that entertainment. It's absolutely core to what we do.
And do you still do knobbly knees? Or is knobbly knees out of the arc?
That's not what people want now. They want things like diversity, Stephen Mulhern, Teletubbies, things like that, that are very current, that's suitable for the whole family.
And do we need to celebrate Skegness more? Because, I mean, it is amazing, but sometimes it doesn't get celebrated enough.
I think people do take it for granted. It is a real jewel. And I think one of the key figures that came out today, the 60% increase in visitor numbers between October and March.
I mean, that's phenomenal, isn't it? That really is phenomenal.
It is. And people now appreciate that we're an all-year-round resort and we're growing employment. 500 people more employed last year, 7% growth. This is something the whole area should be really proud of.
And one of the key things is it to extend that season and make it longer?
It is. People need to understand we're about careers, not just jobs. Butlins employs 900 people in the middle of January. 20 years ago, nobody would have thought that was possible.
And do you have some famous guests who come and stay at Butlins?
We've had a few that just turn up. I remember Johnny Vegas, Chris Evans has been there. They just come.
Well,
they
bring their families.
Yeah, and they come because it's part of their history as well, and they like doing that sort of thing.
Chris, it's very good to see you. Thank you very much indeed. Continue the success. You can have a chat with the Jolly Fisherman. Hi there, Jolly Fisherman. Now, if you are going to come to Skegness and spend some time here, then you need somewhere to stay. And all across this town, there are dozens and dozens of hotels and B&Bs, many of them along the Grand Promenade here, just across the way. Well, our reporter, Philip Norton, has spent the last 24 hours with Alan and Jackie, poor Alan and Jackie is all I would say, who run the Rufford Hotel.
I'm Alan.
I'm Jackie.
And we run the Rufford Hotel in Skegness.
Three nights at the motel, under street lights in the city of palms. Call me what you want when you want, if you want.
We're sort of people who thrive off people enjoying themselves and knowing they're happy.
Hello, sir.
Hello there.
Early last year, Alan and Jackie quit their jobs as a lorry driver and hairdresser on the south coast. They made Skegness their home, and for visitors, a home from home.
There you go.
Thank you so much. Working away from home, I'm from Kingston upon Hull originally. Had some friends stay here before, so they've recommended it, and here we are.
Life running this hotel is busy.
Oh dear, all fun here. Washing it out, just when Jackie just washed it, it's all out, ready to be ironed. Mobility scooters. Quick dash to move them and around the side of the cover now.
Three nights at the motel under streetlights in the city of palms.
With evening meals, we can do up to 28 people, which we have done in the past. Quite hectic, but still very good.
I'm 85 now and I've known Skegness all my life. I'm here on my own because I like it here. They're very nice. It's very friendly, very homely. Very everything, really. I love it.
Least of all your problems, you can't reach me if you want to stay up tonight. Stay up at night.
In the fridge, we have the sausages and bacon. It's all counted out. So in the morning, get everything out, on the oven, job done, hopefully.
If that's all you got, I have to have another woo-woo.
No, have another woo-woo.
Come from Loughborough, in Leicestershire.
A bit of time away, is it?
Yeah, from the husbands and that lot, yes. I just sleep like a log tonight, having a couple of these. I don't normally drink, but
no, we don't.
It's going a bit to my head now. It is.
Night-night.
So it's 1:15. I think I just heard the doorbell go twice. Oops.
They're really friendly with a hotel. You just with yourselves, you don't meet anyone.
It's more intimate, you know, it's more friendly. You get the personal touch.
It's easy to forget. People come here, they've saved all year. They come here for their holiday. Might be the only chance to get away. And we try and make it the best one. This is a holiday location. We try our best for them, and we hope you do.
Yeah.
We enjoy it. We enjoy people enjoying life.
I'll see you.
Bye. Yeah, but he's eaten them out of house and home, having a full English this morning. If you look very carefully, you can see him. He's right up there on the pier. Now, that looked good, but it also looked like hard work to me.
Yeah, it's really, really hard work. And you know what? Seeing it firsthand just shows just how much it's a real labour of love for these people like Alan and Jackie, who run these small hotels and B&Bs. You know, they only had about an hour and a half to themselves last night. They ordered a takeaway in. They said, this is our me time now. But even then, after then, they were still coming through saying, do you want a cup of tea? Asking the guests if they were okay. And yes, you know, it's people like that that give that personal touch that keeps people coming back to Skegness year after year. Yes, you can choose your chain hotels if you like and come and stay in those for a night, but they're saying that it's hotels and service that Alan and Jackie give that keeps people coming year after year.
Phil, thank you very much indeed. There he is, Phil, with all his friends, but we have got friends here. And thank you very much indeed for watching this special live from Skegness, celebrating the success of the resort. And I have to say as well, the RNLI are out tonight doing a training exercise, and hopefully we'll get a little glimpse of them a little bit later on. But the coxswain there is retiring. I went to see the lifeboat earlier on, looking fabulous. Abby is here. Enjoying yourself?
I'm having a lovely time, yes.
Oh,
thank
good,
you.
Good, good, good. I was sort of half hoping that it might rain at the start just to find out whether the forecast was accurate, because there was no rain.
There was no rain.
There was no rain.
And it's bone dry.
Yes.
We know what we're talking about.
You know what you're talking about.
Yeah, would you believe it? I do.
Yeah. Did you?
Paul.
Now, you used to come here as a kid, didn't you?
Yes, I used to come here as a kid, went to Butlins a few times, and actually did my first shift for the BBC ever right here.
What were you doing?
Come full circle. We were doing like a World War II commemoration thing. Right. It's about 8 or 9 years ago. It's nice to be back.
Okay.
Thanks for